It's Hannah here, and today we're in Southampton and we're going to be testing the F101. I'm here with Rob from Foiling World. So can you just tell us a little bit about the boat, why it's different to what we've already seen and who it's aimed at?
I suppose it's aimed at people who want to get into foiling, and some of the other platforms are slightly more extreme, and we tried to, in the design of this, build out all of the aspects that could lead to crashes and everything like that, so that you can just learn about foiling and worry less about capsizing and some of the other fun bits of foiling.
So I guess it's a little bit more accessible than some of the other boats that are already on the market.
I suppose for somebody who's already into sailing and where fitness might be a factor in terms of their foiling journey, then this solves quite a number of those fitness issues.
So we're here at Sailing Club, and hopefully we can see people who have come from lasers and other kind of hiking monohulls who could take their club racing skills and apply them to this boat quite quickly.
Yeah, absolutely. If you can sheet like you would in a laser or an aero, then you'll be fine for when the apparent wind kicks in, and then you can do that rapid sheeting that will get you up and foiling.
I've heard that it's pretty much impossible to capsize and really impossible to pitch pole. Tell us a bit about the features on the boat which mean that it behaves like that.
I suppose this sort of the trimaran configuration helps. The length is the key factor that stops it pitch poling, and the bows are sort of wave piercing bows, so they can go under the water, but then the buoyancy will fire it back up, which stops you pitch poling. And these extra floats, they allow you to start with the rig on top of you and the foil at a great angle, because the boat's sort of canted to windward. And if you do make a mistake, then these floats just stop you having that last little bit of the capsize, and then you can have another go and try and get up and foiling the next time.
So a lot less opportunity for swimming and tiring yourself out, and more opportunity for getting up and foiling.
Absolutely.
And there's a couple of different options. We can have just the main, we've got a zero, and then we've also got a self-tacking jib. Tell us what kind of conditions you'd use each of them in.
The boat has been used quite a lot in foiling schools, and the zero that just comes out of the furler there, that just gives you loads of power for light winds. It's really easy to steer to, and that in very light winds, 6 knots, that gives you enough power to get up and foiling. And then as the wind speed increases, you can get rid of the zero. But more importantly, as your ability as a foiler improves, then the self-tacker might come into its own. As you start concentrating more on manoeuvres, then of course the self-tacker looks after itself. So the boat allows, the options allows the boat to grow with your ability down the foiling route, really.
Amazing, so plenty of different options.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems like this kind of really caters towards an area of the market where there wasn't something specifically for them to begin with, so that's really great. And just to cover again, how much would I have to spend to get one of these brand new?
These are, I think, 21,000 including VAT in the UK.
Brilliant. So we've just come back off the water, had a really great sail. If you've tried something like the Wasp or the Moth and you found that it was a bit too tricky for you, I'd definitely recommend trying the F101. Really nice, easy way into foiling, and then quite tricky to keep yourself on the foil, so something for everyone there. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and don't forget you can find lots of other awesome videos on dinghy racing on the Dinghy Racing channel.